Something in your voice, something in your eyes. I don't feel so lost, and I don't have to hide. Something has set me free, and I don't mind.
All right, that's Lizz Wright, Eternity. That is one of my most favorite songs of all time. I will be seeing this vocalist yet again in concert. I wanted to see her on my birthday, October 30th. In Paris, I think in Paris, I know it's in France, but, she popped up with, a concert the next day, October 31st, in London. So I just purchased my ticket this morning, and I cannot wait. I have seen her twice. The very first time was in Atlanta around year 2006 or 2007. My mom and I traveled to Atlanta. We just moved to Mobile, Alabama about like a year prior. And like around that time is when I found out about Lizz Wright, and I just was blown away. And I was like, she has any concert nearby, I'm going to go watch her. My mom was like, yeah, I'll go with you. So we went, and I was just like, oh my goodness. Woo. She is like, there's no words to even describe. Because to me, her music just puts me on a whole nother level. Where it's literally like, right now I'm feeling so sad and angry. About my mommy being gone, and just seeing people whose parents are still alive, and, you know, people I used to know, and they're just, like, having a good time in their life, and right now I'm just, like, you know, right now I can't go back to sleep, so it's just because I have all this stuff on my mind, just, so I'm listening to music, and here I am listening to Lizz Wright again, and I used to sit in my apartment. I had an apartment for about only 4 months, some years ago before I joined the military, and I tried to do it on my own, just didn't work out. But I used to sit in my apartment and just listened to her albums. I have all of her CDs, and I used to just sit there and let them play, and it would just bring me like into peace and serenity, and it still does even today. So just listening to her song Eternity just brings me to that point where, I can just sit there and just take in everything and just be at that level of meditation. And so I'll play one more song by her. It's called Dreaming Wide Awake. And so I have asked her if she could perform Eternity at her concert since my birthday's October 30th. I'm turning 31, so super excited. I know I look young. Damn, I get it all the time. And I'm gonna have a video on my birthday twins. They're celebrities, obviously. I only met one person in my whole life who shared my birthday. And that was like a year and a half ago. So they were like almost like not twice my age, but close to it. But she even looked young. So long story short, my celebrity birthday twins are Nia Long. So as you can see, Nia Long looks young, doesn't she? And she's like, just, it's just awesome to see. Like at her age, and she looks like, she could pass for like in her 20s, okay? So, I get it too, honey. Like people always think I'm like a teenager still, and I'm like, no. And they don't even believe me, so they have to like look at my ID or some proof of my age. Yes, honey, I was born October 30th, 1984. Thank you. And so my next birthday twin, and we're exactly birthday twins. Like we share the same exact birthday. Eva Pickford, so America's Top Model. So yes, so that's pretty cool. And I also share a birthday with Harry Winkler, the actor, as well as musician Gavin Rosdell and Matthew Morrison, I believe is his name. He plays on Glee as like the teacher. And who else? Michael Beach. He played in Soul Food movie as the husband that cheats. And then Donald Trump's daughter, I think it's Ivanka Trump, I believe is her name. But yeah, so yes. So it's pretty cool. But yeah, I'm gonna make a video on that. Just because, I look at them as like influence, especially just like in the fact that I look young, so especially Nia Long. I get it everywhere I go. Almost every day, I hear somebody thinks I'm young, and I'm like, no, I'm 30, or I'll be 31, and they just don't believe me. So, yeah, and then I can see it too. My face is I just look young. But like my sister, I just spoke to my sister Sunday. Yeah, I just love Lizz Wright. Oh man, I was feeling so bad. Like, I mean, I was really angry. I was crying like 30 minutes ago, and just listening to her just, let me know I'm okay. But yeah, my sister, I was talking to her Sunday and on the telephone, and one thing about me is people mistake my innocent face as, my personality. I'm gonna be nice and so sweet. No. And I'm for real. So my sister describes me as, I've never heard this until today. So, I mean, until then. So I was like, this is a good, I guess, analogy or metaphor, whatever. You know what I'm talking about. She said, you're like a puppy. You're like a puppy. So people want to like pick up the puppy and just play with the puppy. You're so cute. But then that puppy will bite that person's head off in a heartbeat, and it'll be a hard bite. And I was like, yep, that is me. I think it's so funny because it's true. Like, people always mistake me for, oh, you're so sweet and you won't hurt a fly. No, honey. I'm very opinionated. Look, I like to voice my opinion. I am judgmental, but I love to learn too. So, I may be judgmental, but I'm very open to having discussions and just being aware of things that I don't know of and being corrected. Now, you can't correct me in a fashion of being mean, but if we actually have a real conversation, I'll be fine. But yeah, so. But I love that. But I had to feel better. I'm slowly feeling a little bit better. I think I can go back to sleep now because I've been up for about 2 hours, not now. And I have to work late at night, so yep. All right, well, this was for me just to reminisce and feel sad and angry about my mommy passing. Because I really miss my mommy. I just feel it's not fair. My mommy was wonderful. Even when we disagreed, but you know what? She was wonderful. She was very supportive. She always wanted to talk to me and make sure her baby was okay, as well as her other baby, my sister Tiffany. So, yeah. But, all right. Bye.